All right, so you're kicking off your content strategy and you want to know what type of content gets lots and lots of links. Most SEOs know about the process of competitive analysis, where you basically drop in your competitors into a backlink checker or a site explorer like Ahrefs, see what has done well for them, and then you replicate it, build on it, take the germ of the idea and run with it. Take what has worked, do more of it. But your competitors are too limiting. One tactic that I've found in developing successful content strategies is to take giant publishers, like magazines and newspapers, who are sort of, even if they're not in your industry, at least complementary to it. So let's suppose you have a construction business, a landscape business, you know, home building business. The publisher, the big publisher in your industry, is Better Homes and Gardens. All they do is publish content. They publish lots and lots of it. They have a good eye for it. And they've just been doing it for a very, very long time. So the idea here is to do almost a content analysis on what's working for them and use that to build out your own content strategy so that you're not wasting time on content that is not going to perform. So it's pretty straightforward. Take, you know, the main domain, bhg.com. You know, if you're in the finance, this might be Barron's or even Wall Street Journal, and drop it into Ahrefs Site Explorer with the domain, so you're looking at everything. Go to the top content report, and we're going to sort by links. Because remember, just because content is popular doesn't mean that content is going to get you links. Sometimes, actually a lot of times, something may do well on Twitter, it may do well on Pinterest, but it will not get the attention of the people who can actually link to your content. All right, so you have it sorted by links. Now, the top five or six are often going to be, you know, category pages, the top level page. You can ignore that. That's normal. Those are getting brand pickups. What you can do is skip down, and what we're looking for is specific content that has done really well and gotten lots of links. So at number six, we have a winner. Curb appeal. That's something, so 20 ways to add curb appeal has done particularly well with lots and lots of links. And again, you can check and see exactly who is linking to that piece of content and see if that's what, you know, the type of content that you want. Number two, how to clean carpet. All right, so this is a reference piece. And again, we can go over and see what is doing well there. Ideas to steal for your apartment, cheap chic headboard projects. Anyway, we can go on and on. And again, see this type of content, this curb appeal, it got links from, you know, some that are in the industry, but also from a lot of very small bloggers that for whatever reason they've linked to it. So if you can build a more authoritative or a better angle on it, you know, how to build better curb appeal with landscaping. These are the type of people that you can reach out to. You can take it in whatever direction you want. But either way, there's something about that curb appeal that gets lots and lots of links. Same way with how to clean carpet. And just to show you the scale of what we're talking about, there are 31,161 pieces of content on bhg.com. And what we're able to do is look at the top 50, top 100, whatever you want to look through, and find out that this piece on curb appeal, out of 31,000 pieces of content, this is a lot of testing, that this one got the most links. So what we can go through is basically cherry pick the most successful pieces of content, put our own spin, our own angle, and then use this as our sort of seed list to go ahead and link out to. And so that's just a quick and easy way to find the type of content, the type of angles that are going to work really, really well in your industry. And again, if links aren't your goal, if you want to build up Facebook or Pinterest, you just sort by that, see what does well, reverse engineer it, put your own spin on it, and you'll have a much, much better shot at success than you would just throwing darts into the dark, trying to pre-qualify content.